the Lord. Hallelujah. It's another good day. We give glory to God for this opportunity. Okay, let us pray. Father, we thank you for this morning. We appreciate you. Thank you for your grace made sufficient for us. Thank you for your anointing, O God, made available unto us, that you keep sustaining our lives. We appreciate you. We thank you for this very new day you've given to us. And we pray that this day will be a glorious day, will be a wonderful day, and a peaceful day. Take control, Lord Jesus. Minister to us. Speak to us, O God, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. You can pause this video for a minute or two and worship the Lord. And when you are through with your worship, then you pause it and continue. We'll start to pray. I also advise that after each prayer point given, pause the video and make the prayer. Pray with all your heart, with all your mind. And then when you are through with that very point, then you can pause it and listen to the second prayer point, and so on and so forth until we are through the whole video. Hallelujah. Let the living water flow over my soul. Let your Holy Spirit come and take control of every situation that has troubled my mind. All my cares and burdens unto thee I roll. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Spirit, Spirit, Spirit. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let your living water flow over our soul this moment. Please let your Holy Spirit take control. Direct us, O God, guide us. Fill our hearts with your anointing. I rededicate this devotion to the hands of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Today, we want to look at unshakable peace. Our main text is from Philippians chapter 4, verse 7. The New Life Version says, "The peace of God is much greater than the human mind can understand. This peace will keep your heart and mind through Christ Jesus." Isaiah chapter 26 verse 3 says, "You will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you." What is peace? Merriam-Webster dictionary defines peace as a state of tranquility or quiet, freedom from disquieting or oppressive thoughts or emotions, a state of security or order within a community provided for by law or custom. And God Almighty is referred to in the scriptures in Judges chapter 6, verse 24 as Jehovah Shalom. That means Jehovah is peace. That is the name that Gideon gave to the altar which he erected at Ophrah, where the angel appeared to him. The Hebrew word Shalom means peace, harmony, wholeness, completeness, prosperity, welfare, and tranquility, and can be used idiomatically to mean both hello or goodbye. I got that from Wikipedia. Now, having defined peace, or the Hebrew word shalom, which is peace, then we can say that Jehovah Shalom, God our peace, God is the source of peace, and is the source of our welfare, is the source of our prosperity, is the source of our wholeness, is the source of our completeness, he is the source of our tranquility, he is the source of the quietness within us. So if we need unshakable peace, the only source we can get this from is God Almighty. And this is through the Holy Spirit. And we realize and we know of a truth that peace is part of the fruit of the Spirit. Now, let's look at the enemies of peace so I will know exactly how to go about getting this peace and how to protect our peace. Now, which are the enemies of peace? Anxiety is number one. Anxiety and worry, which can lead to disease condition. And we all know that worry is a weight. Worry weighs you down, makes you to become even depressed, downcast. When you worry, you become downcast, you become heavy, you might become dejected, and you become depressed. Philippians 4:6 says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God." Matthew chapter 6, you can read from verse 25 to 34. It says, reading from the New Living Translation, verse 25, that is why I tell you not to worry about everyday life. Jesus is saying here, we should not worry about everyday life, whether you have enough food and drink or enough clothes to wear. Isn't life more than food and your body more than clothing? Look at the birds. They don't plant or harvest or store food in barns, for your heavenly Father feeds them. And aren't you far more valuable to him than they are? Verse 27, can all your worries add a single moment to your life? And why worry about your clothing? Look at the lilies of the field and how they grow. They don't work and make their clothing. Yet Solomon in all his glory was not dressed as beautifully as they are. Verse 30, and if God cares so wonderfully for wild flowers that are here today and thrown into the fire tomorrow, he will certainly care for you. Why do you have so little faith? Verse 31, so don't worry about these things, saying, what will we eat? What will we drink? What will we wear? These things dominate the thoughts of unbelievers, but your heavenly Father already knows all your needs. Seek the kingdom of God above all else and live righteously, and he will give you everything you need. Don't worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring its own worries. Today's trouble is enough for today. And that was why Jesus had to advise Martha. He looked at Martha. Martha was so worried, so concerned about keeping things perfect, fixing everything. She was there. She was even trying to fix her sister, Mary. She told Jesus, why are you just watching? Why not tell Mary to join me? You see, that is one of the problems we have, we human beings have. We try to play God and try to fix everything around us, try to fix people around us. And you know that except God does it, no one can do it. And Jesus said to her, I'm talking about Luke chapter 10 from verse 41 to 42. Jesus said, Martha, dear Martha, you are using far too much and getting yourself worked up over nothing. One thing is essential and Mary has chosen it. It's the main cause and it won't be taken from her. That's the Message translation. The Amplifier says, but the Lord replied to her, Martha, Martha, you are worried and bothered and anxious about so many things. So what do people worry about? People worry about what to eat, what to wear, what to drink, according to the scriptures we have just read. And even Martha. Martha also worried about being helped. She worried about how she would get things prepared. And she was so concerned about fixing the table, fixing everything, even fixing Mary. This is exactly the kind of things that Christians worry about. Not even like unbelievers. We worry about what people say about us, what the future holds. What would they say? What would my friend say? What would my mother say? What would my colleague say? We are so bothered about what people will say. We want to please everyone. But who told you you can fix everybody or you can please everybody? You cannot please everybody. No matter what you do, who will hate you will hate you. For your goodness, somebody can just be envious and jealous and hate you for no reason. For your smiles alone, somebody can hate you. And for your greetings alone, somebody can be annoyed. So no matter what you do, who will hate you will hate you. You cannot control that. We can't control it. That is their own opinion. We are all entitled to our opinions and to our choices. So they chose to hate you. That is their own. So that should not affect your own choice to be happy. And then we worry about what the future holds. I don't know about tomorrow. And that's why Jesus said there, don't worry about everyday life. Why are you worried about what you wear tomorrow? He said, let tomorrow take off itself. There's no problem for today. You concentrate on today's own. What will your future hold? Beloved, you and I, we don't know what the future holds except God reveals to us. Somebody said, even though we don't know what the future holds, but at least we know who holds the future. I absolutely agree, and that is true. So we worry about almost everything in life. We worry about ourselves. We worry about our husbands. We worry about our wives. We worry about our children. We worry about marriage. When am I going to get married? And then after marriage, you start worrying, how am I going to keep this marriage? Am I going to please my wife? Or how am I going to please my husband? And then when are the children going to come? You start worrying about having children again. And after the children have come, you start worrying again. How am I going to feed this child? How am I going to work with this child? Yeah, I don't know the future of this. I don't know what will happen to this child. You are worried. Every time worried. It's like a school that some people don't even graduate from. Worry from one to state to another. Even after the child has been born, you are worried. All through the life of the child, you are worried. The child comes out, when is this child going to start walking? All her mates are walking. So and so child that was born the same day with my child is already walking. Mine is not working. What is wrong? And you start going from one pillar to another post, just looking for a solution how to get that child to walk. And after that, you start worrying again. Oh, when he starts walking, okay, which school is he going to go to? Even up to the time the child is going to get married, and when he's married, oh, how, when are they going to have children? Worries upon worries upon worries upon worries. Life is filled with so many things, and if you follow life, you'll be worried to death. May God save you and I. Deliver us from this spirit of worries in the name of Jesus. So many things we worry about. Who likes us? Who doesn't like us? What if we fail? What if we don't make it? What if we have COVID? God forbid for us to have COVID. A little cough, you're afraid COVID has come. At times, we use our thoughts and our fears to attract these things to ourselves. I pray God will deliver us in Jesus' name. And then we worry what even what has not happened, we are worried about it. In Mark chapter 16, verse 1 to 3, when Sabbath was passed, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome said among themselves, who will roll away the stones from the door of the tomb for us? They were worrying. But unknown to them, Jesus had already risen, and God's angel had already rolled the stone away and sat on it. Even by the time they got there, there was no more stone blocking the doorway to the tomb. So you see, what we often worry about and are troubled about or anxious about most of the time, God has already taken care of. And some anticipated problems may not even happen. All the things we worry about eventually lead to fear. So that is the second thing that can affect our peace. And that's where I'm going to anchor it today because of time. Fear. False evidence is appearing real. It's not even going to happen. It just appears like it, and you are afraid. I'm at the end. It might not even happen. At times, we even pray with fear. Out of fear, we pray, and we are praying with fear. No faith. And that's what we wonder. Why is this thing not resolving? Why is it not resolving? Because you are praying with fear. But I still thank God that God, in his infinite mercy, when we are in such great danger, we pray even with fear. He still comes to rescue us. But we could do better than that. We could do better than that. Here you are afraid. Just there's a shadow that passes at night, and then, or even a sound you just hear, an unexpected sound you just hear, and you are afraid. Hey, I bind you in the name of Jesus. Fretting about, and you are saying, in Jesus' name, I rebuke you. In Jesus' name, I rebuke you. Out of fear, you are rebuking out of fear right there in the heart. Because of what? False evidences bearing real. John 14:27. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. Job said, what he feared most came upon him. Which means Job was afraid that some of all those blessings he had could disappear one day. He was afraid that his children could commit sin, that they could lose their life, and they could lose their property, they could lose protection. He was afraid of all these things. And he was led by fear to keep offering sacrifices on their behalf. Because of that fear, that anticipated problem he had, and all those things came upon him. And many today are suffering from what they feared most, what their fear attracted to their lives. I pray by God's grace that you and I will not attract any problem or bad issues in life into our lives through fear in the name of Jesus. I take authority and dominion over that spirit of fear, that spirit of anxiety, that spirit of worry that is affecting anyone listening to me. I command those spirits to lose their grips and their hold from your life in the name of Jesus. And I set you free from this bondage. I set you free from this fear. I set you free from this anxiety. I set you free from this worry in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. So I want you to pray these prayer points. Like I told you earlier on, pause the video after each prayer point and pray with all your heart, with all your might. And then when you are finished praying, go to the next one and so on and so forth. So first and foremost, let's just pray. 1 Peter 5:7 says from the Amplified Bible, casting all your cares, all your anxiety, all your worries, and all your concerns once and for all on him, for he cares about you with the deepest affection and watches over you very carefully. So let's begin to speak peace to every area of our life where there are worries, anxiety, concerns, struggles, every unrest, every disease in your life. Speak peace to them in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. So secondly, we need to pray for unshakable peace, peace that remains constant, peace that cannot be disturbed by any situation or condition around me, peace that is beyond human comprehension. Lord, give this peace to me. I receive this peace now into my spirit, into my soul, into my body, into my home, into my family, into my business. Peace that is perfect in the name of Jesus. Amen. Because of time, we're going to pray and say, Lord, strengthen my inner man with your peace. Give me peace within in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And last but not the least, pray and reject the spirits of fear, the spirit of confusion, the spirit of sorrow, the spirit of sin consciousness, and any other spirit that comes to your mind that you know is disturbing your mind and disturbing your heart. Begin to reject them, bind them, and cast them out of your life to the bottom sea forever in the name of Jesus. And it shall be done according to your faith. Whatsoever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever you lose on heaven shall be loosed in heaven. So begin to bind them and set yourself loose in the name of Jesus. Set your family loose. Set your home loose. Set your business loose. Set your day loose. It's going to be a glorious day. Speak into this wonderful day. And this day you are going to be a peaceful day. Rebo Shakaba Santobo Santa. A wonderful day you are going to be. A glorious day in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Our memory verse for today is Philippians 4:7. The peace of God is much greater than the human mind can understand. This peace will keep your heart and mind through Christ Jesus. That's my prayer for you today and all the days of your life. As you keep on serving Christ and believing in him, may the peace that surpasses all human understanding keep your heart and mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And if you are not born again, you need to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Just confess with me. Say, Jesus, I believe in you. You are my Lord and my Savior. I know you died for my sins. You have resurrected and you'll come back again. I surrender my entire being, my spiritual and body to your hands, O God. Take control. Help me. Give me strength and grace to serve you in spirit and in truth until you come. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. So I believe, God, that you are born again, beloved, as you have confessed that since from your heart. Don't forget, beloved, righteousness is a nation. A sin is a reproach to other people. God bless you.